Hello, I'm Shankar Descharma of the University of Maryland, and today I'll be talking about fractional quantum Hall effect, which is one of the most amazing and also one of the most important physics discoveries of the last 50 years. What was discovered by Suhi, Stormer, and Gossard of Bell Laboratories in 1982 was when you go to a very high magnetic field, a two-dimensional electron gas, happens to be semiconductors, that's why they exist, shows fractional quantization of Hall conductance in units of E square over H. Now, what do I mean by fractional quantization? Well, let's take a step back and talk about integer quantum Hall effect a little bit. In 1980, Klaus von Klitzing discovered that a two-dimensional electron gas subjected to a very strong magnetic field shows integer quantization, which basically means that the Hall resistance, Hall conductance, is quantized in units of E square over H when you have an integer number of lambda levels occupied. When you apply a strong magnetic field to two-dimensional electron gas, the system decomposes, the density of cells decomposes into a bunch of lambda levels. So as you move the chemical potential or as you increase magnetic field, that means as you change electron density or you change magnetic field, your Fermi level is moving through lambda levels. So you can have a certain number of lambda levels occupied. And what Klaus von Klitzing found that the quantum, the Hall resistance or Hall conductance is quantized, and the quantization number corresponds to the number of integral filling of lambda levels. So it was natural to go to a situation where the lowest lambda level is occupied, meaning make the magnetic field large enough so that you have partial filling of the lowest lambda level. What we expected, and I was an active researcher at that time, so I remember the feeling precisely, we all expected that the system will form some kind of a lattice called Wigner crystal or perhaps a charge density wave. Why? Because you know the system would want to minimize potential energy. When you go to the lowest lambda level, you basically have no kinetic energy left, right? You have only zero point energy, h bar omega c divided by 2. It's a constant. So if all the lambda levels are well separated, that means in the high magnetic field limit, you just have potential energy. Well, we thought the system will minimize potential energy by forming a lattice, just as ions form in a solid. Ions form a lattice, electrons form a gas or a liquid. The reason is that ions are trying to minimize potential energy, and in a quantum system, minimize potential energy by staying away from each other by forming a lattice. Well, that didn't happen. What happened, we found out, is the system formed an incompressible quantum liquid. Bob Laughlin wrote down a wave function for this liquid, and he showed that you have gaps at this fractional filling, where the fractional filling goes as 1 over m, m being an odd denominator. So the original fraction 1/3, now we know it can happen at 1/5, and so on. But later on, we found out that this fractional quantum Hall effect can take place generically at any fractional filling, p over q, where q is an odd number and p could be anything. Why? The reason is the system actually minimizes energy by forming an incompressible quantum liquid, by forming gaps at these odd denominator fractions. Very strange system where the minimization is associated with formation of an incompressible quantum liquid, and it's incompressible because there is an energy gap. Now we know from integer quantum Hall effect that having a gap is equivalent to having quantization of the Hall resistance or Hall conductance. So that's exactly what happens in a fractional quantum Hall effect. Just like integer quantum Hall effect, the Hall conductance is quantized, but now not at integer filling, but at fractional filling, because the system has formed this incompressible, strongly correlated liquid because the original non-interacting system had a macroscopic degeneracy. All the electrons in the thermodynamic limit, infinite number of electrons, but even for real system, trillions of electrons, billions of electrons, have exactly the same non-interacting energy. So the system has this macroscopic degeneracy, which leads to this very strange incompressible liquid. So when you look at this liquid, it's characterized by a gap, but it's characterized by something even more interesting, more bizarre. The excitations of this system above this incompressible ground state are fractionally charged excitations. This follows very easily from the fact that the quantum Hall effect is quantized now by this fraction. It's a fractional multiples of these E square over H. So that means whatever is carrying this Hall current must carry fractional charge. And this very intuitive heuristic argument can be actually made rigorous through topological argument that indeed the excitations are fractional excitation, and these excitations are what are called abelian excitations. They're anions. They're not fermions. They're not bosons. When you take them around each other twice, instead of going back to where they started, they pick up a phase. Well, they may pick up a phase, I should say, and for fractional quantum Hall system, they indeed pick up a phase. And so, although fractional quantum Hall system looks like integer quantum Hall system, with the only difference that you have fractional Hall quantization rather than integer quantum Hall quantization, there is a huge difference. The excitations for integer quantum Hall effect are integer charge excitations here, they're fractional charge excitations. But this similarity in their phenomenology actually is quite powerful, and it leads to the concept of composite fermions, which are central to the understanding of fractional quantum Hall effect.